Well, it's that time of year again when wheat combines are rolling through farmers' fields. This year's harvest looks to be a good one, thanks to some favorable growing conditions. Yet for our country to remain the breadbasket of the world, it's going to take more than just Mother Nature's cooperation. Today, we continue with the innovative work of an Oklahoman to develop wheat varieties that are as tough as they are productive. It's a challenging proposition, but one that's music to the ears of OSU's Brett Carver. If wheat is the staff of life, then Brett Carver is its shepherd.
I'm a wheat breeder, and what that means is I try to make wheat better. I try to do it by taking the genetics that's in the plant and tweaking it a little bit, taking the best genetic pieces and putting them together. We call that a variety, and I call a variety a stimulus package. It's something that stimulates the economy, it stimulates a farmer's profitability, stimulates a lot of things that make our economies grow.
Planted since the time of the Pharaohs, it's a basic food that can be found in virtually every society.
It is truly the plant of the world. And in fact, it's what got our civilization started. And we still depend on it today, despite some who might demonize it and say, you know, we shouldn't. And I think as wheat goes in the future, I think we will go. It's that important in our diet and our civilization.
And for Carver, unlocking the mysteries of this ancient grain is just as much a passion as is his music.
I've always had a musical desire, just growing up. You know, it was either going to be science or it was going to be music. And, you know, I decided at a pretty young age, well, it's going to be science. But that doesn't mean you have to drop everything else. And so I've kind of kept the music alive and enjoyed that opportunity to go get away. You know, that's my release. Your mind goes off into another area, another stratosphere. You know, if you're really connected to that music. My math ability was improved by learning music. There really is a math component to music. Breaking things down according to meter and time and rhythm. And there's a mathematical component of that that I think crosses over. And science really does draw upon mathematical ability.
A connection Carver calls upon inside these research greenhouses.
Looking back, I say, oh my gosh, yeah, this is where some of that math really came into play, literally play. And every chance I get, I like to incorporate, you know, music into what we do here in terms of how we name varieties. The most recent Stardust, that goes strictly back to a very, very popular American song written in 1927. The composer, Hoagy Carmichael, one of the most widely recorded songs in America. That song in and of itself is a symbol of versatility. When you can take a song and record it 1,500 different times, 1,500 different recordings, that tells me that that song has a lot of versatility. And that is exactly the way we need to look at white wheat.
Because just like its name, Stardust mills much wider, like the stars in the sky.
White wheat gives us some versatility in the marketplace that we haven't yet taken advantage of from our crop here in Oklahoma. And I hope that's a big part of our future.
And on that note, another wheat harvest is underway. Now this spring, Carver was honored at the state capitol with Governor Fallon's Outstanding Public Service Award in Agriculture.